Why did it take so long for Meatloaf to have his second album?
Well, he just, his voice went. It's really actually a simple answer. He had no voice. Tried to sing and couldn't. And the songs I wrote, that album that I did, Bad for Good, was planned as his second album. He couldn't sing it at all, tried desperately. Literally for about, I think, 14 to 15 months, I was in the studio almost every night, 6 hours a night with him. And I'd say at the end we got possibly 3 lines that could be used, which is, I'm sure, seems ridiculously exaggerated to somebody, but I swear to God, it's the truth. 3 lines at most. And they all sounded like Linda Blair in The Exorcist, the little girl. I mean, it was horrifying. It was like, and, you know, what do you say when you hear a line like that? I mean, you know, he'd sing a line and go, you say, that sounds a little flat. Go, that's better, you know. It was pretty frustrating, and it was horrifying for him, I'm sure. And the record company, all they knew is the first record sold 10 million copies, so, you know, somebody can do something. They just think, this is ridiculous, you don't lose your voice like this. And so everyone went through hell for a while, and finally, he decided that the best thing was for me to write another record, because those songs had become like curses. I mean, just even hearing them would terrify him. So I decided to do that record and at the same time write another record for him. But he still had vocal problems. And I ended up, I started the next record with Jimmy Iovine, both of us producing. And both of us ended up leaving the project, sort of by mutual consent with Meatloaf, because we couldn't get him to sing, and he was having problems.
Dead Ringer was the new album by
him.
Yeah,
that was the one I wrote.
And you did actually have a top five single in England with the Cher Meatloaf duet.
Yeah, duet, Dead Ringer, which is a really good song, too.
I remember you've been hanging around this joint. You've been trying to look away, but now you finally got the point.
Knowing your great interest in films, I must ask if you were involved in the video of Total Eclipse of the Heart.
Oh, yeah. I write the songs with the videos in mind, and that was one really, I think I had the idea for the video in mind simultaneously with the song, and half the reason I did that song was to get to do a video, work on a video, and I wanted so much to work with Russell Mulcahy. The videos I had seen, I just thought he was a genius. Most of them were terrible videos that I had seen, and then his came along, and they were dazzling. And I was so thrilled that it worked out that he could do it. And I wrote it and storyboarded it and staged a lot of it because he'd been in Australia. It was really nice of him even to take it on because he was exhausted. He had been doing so much work. And he came and he directed it. And so it reflected both personalities. It's like his personality and mine.
And I need you now tonight. And I need you more than ever. And if you only hold me tight, we'll be home.
You had a number one in Britain with Total Eclipse of the Heart, and then, surprise, surprise, doing better than that in the States, having one and two at the same time, when that was one you had Air Supply at two in the States.
Yeah.
Like you do, making love out of nothing at all.
anybody who has a sense of irony must have been amused when you took a Meatloaf song for Barry Manilow.
Yeah, well, actually, what happened there was they asked me to write an original. I had no time. And I couldn't write an original, so I suggested to the president of the record company that he listen to this second Meatloaf album, because there were all these songs that got ignored. No one really heard them. I thought they were good songs, and I thought that one would be appropriate. And he did, and decided he was going to do it. They wanted to do it, and I felt, well, if he's going to do it, I should produce it, because I want to protect the song, make sure it's done right. So again, it was in service of the song. And besides, I thought it'd be fun if I could someday, if I ever had grandchildren, or if I ran an orphanage, I could say to all the little tykes, I did a Barry Manilow record. They'd throw porridge at my face and things. And it was just another experience, just something to do. I mean, it was a bizarre one. We did it, it was like 2 days, and also I got the chance to work with Elton John's band, which is one of my favorite bands of all time, and Davy Johnston, Dee Murray, and Nigel Olsen.
I've been trying for hours just to think of what exactly to say. I thought I'd leave you with a letter or a fire, a speech, like when an actor makes an exit at the end of a play. And I've been dying for hours trying to fill up all the holes with some sense. I'd like to give you all the reasons and what everything meant. Well, I could tell you goodbye.
And in the not too distant future, you'd like to direct yourself.
Well, yeah, that's all I've ever wanted to do. I mean, that's what I think I'm doing when I'm doing records. I just think I'm doing movies. I act as if I am, and eventually that's all I've always wanted to do is direct films. Just because you can use musicals, what I always wanted to do, because there really haven't been any. I mean, there haven't been much. There's West Side Story has always been one of my favorites. You know, to me, when I listened to Bruce Springsteen the first time, all I could think of is this guy was one of the Jets in West Side Story, and he just got out and became a great songwriter. And since West Side Story, I mean, it's been pretty much trash. I mean, Grease is something you wouldn't even want to find in your toilet one day. And stuff like, I mean, Saturday Night Fever is hardly a musical. It had great stuff in it, but it was just songs stuck in. I mean, it wasn't really a musical. And I'd like to do something. I mean, I've written one. I've written this Peter Pan thing. That's my dream project, which I hope to do, which is a rock and roll Peter Pan, because ultimately I grew up with Peter Pan. Again, it's one of my favorite stories, and I still think it's one of the great rock and roll stories.